Hey y'all, what's up? It is Jillian here, and it is week 23 of my sugar-free year, and I'd say it's been a pretty productive week. I am pretty proud of myself, if I don't mind saying. So, hopping right into it, this week I've been kind of doing like a preliminary keto whole foods like check-in. So I've been reading up on keto a little bit more and more, all the carbs and whatnot. So I've been looking at packages, you know, avoiding things that have like the max amount of carbs you're supposed to have on keto and stuff. And the turkey bowl meal that I had been having for a couple weeks now, I made it keto simply by switching out the brown rice for cauliflower rice. Still kind of wary of cauliflower rice on its own because of kind of like that crunchy texture of it. It's definitely not rice, but with it mixed in with the turkey and the carrots and the broccoli and some sriracha, you really can't taste it. So it's like, you know, making a kind of decently healthy meal that much more healthy by getting rid of all that carby stuff and just sticking to like some really good whole foods. So I'm really excited about that. I can't wait to make it again. You know, it's just, I didn't feel tired afterwards. I didn't feel weighed down. I felt really great. And so I'm, you know, just really proud of that. And so, yeah, I went to Trader Joe's and I did another run. I got more just vegetables and things. I'm not full on keto or anything right now. So I'm, you know, there's still some things where I'm breaking the rules of that. Definitely like those little Trader Joe's like fruit wraps, like kind of like their version of like a fruit by the foot, or not fruit by the foot, fruit roll up. I love fruit roll up. I love a good fruit roll up. But Trader Joe's and Whole Foods, everyone has like those kind of more natural ones. And I did find the ones at Trader Joe's that don't have any added sugar. Of course, like their carb is like 15 grams or whatever, which is still not like, I don't think that's crazy, especially because it's natural sugar. It's not added any sugar. So look, I committed to one thing for the year. There's no added sugar, and that's still what I'm doing. I'm tacking on the keto thing eventually because I want to see how well I can do with that. But for the time being, we're still playing with the lines of all that. I watched Fed Up this week, the documentary. It's been out for a few years now. It's all about the sugar industry and how evil it is. You know, you see your tested rats and how like the one that's on sugar is like way more addicted than the one that's like on cocaine, and it's like, oh, okay, that's terrifying. And you know, just these people in these documentaries who are like, I'm watching the labels and I'm reading, you know, what's on the package, and I put back the stuff that says like, oh, it's got a lot of fat in it, but it's like, really, it's like, that's not what's hurting you. It's really just like all the sugar that is in everything, even the healthy things that you think, which of course, like even when I started doing this, like it was an eye opener. So just kind of reiterating why I'm doing this for myself by watching the show. I was thinking earlier this week just about, like, I don't know, I saw an ad or something, or maybe I was just in the store and I thought of like gummy worms, like sour gummy worms, and how much I love them. And you know, it's gotten to that point now where it's like, ah, man, at like this age in my life, I can't imagine being that person that eats those as often as I did up until this point, because it's just rotten for you. It's so bad for you. And like, as much as I love them, like, I hope that I don't turn back to that immediately when I'm done with this year, because, you know, that is just pure sugar. And you know, and I'm proud of myself for thinking that thought of like, wow, I did that. Like, that was how bad it was for me. You know, that was kind of like my addiction, you know, it was that intense. And so I'm hopefully not gonna head right back into the sour worms anytime soon. And to think that there are people in this world who never eat that, you know, it's like, wow, you must have self-control. Or maybe it's just the fact that you never got so hooked on it. I don't know, because I was pretty hooked. They are good, so maybe farewell, sour gummy worms. I don't know. Maybe not. Not saying goodbye forever, but definitely not quite as often as I would eat them, which was a lot. The last woohoo thing of this week that I'll talk about is the other day it was National Donut Day, and I think donuts might be like my favorite sugary awesome thing in the world. It's got that perfect cakey texture along with like a nice glaze on top, like your sprinkles. Can get any flavor, can get crazy. There's vegan ones now. That wasn't a thing when I was growing up. Krispy Kreme is like a North Carolina staple. Dunkin' Donut in New York is kind of the staple, but also in New York, there's so many donuts. So anyway, like the idea that the other day was National Donut Day was actually kind of bumming me out because everyone was posting like, this is where I got my free donut, and just anything about donuts, it's everywhere, it's in your face. I love them, I miss them. I definitely love a good donut. So I looked up a recipe from the Sugar Free Londoner. It's a blog I have found a couple of things from. I think that's where I got my chocolate chip cookie from. But found a donut recipe. It's like a keto sugar-free donut recipe. I had almost all the ingredients already at home. Really, really easy stuff like almond flour, some of the swerve sweetener, vanilla, and baking powder. I think it was baking powder. Some eggs. That might have been it. And yeah, I think that was it. Oh, and heavy cream. So of course they're not, obviously with it being keto, they're not necessarily vegan, which is what I usually try to do, but nevertheless, I wanted a donut and I made myself a donut. And these are a day old, so they don't look as good, but here is my mini donut I made in a regular cupcake pan because I did not have a donut pan. And now that I see that I can make them, and they're really not bad, they're really, this one is a glaze. I also made some that were just like a sugar cinnamon sugar combo, and they were like a more dry like cakey one. Pop these in the oven for like 20 minutes maybe, I think. And yeah, I made my own donuts this week. They're sugar-free and they're pretty good. I was worried about the swerve because it does have that like cooling effect. That's what it was that hit me the first time I tried to make something with swerve. I was like, why does my mouth feel so cold? Like what? It's like piercing. And I looked it up and it's like, oh, that's an actual weird reaction that is in that sugar for some reason. But this time it wasn't as like hitting me in the face with it, especially because I put these in the fridge after a day, so like they're already cold when I bite into them, so it's like blends in. But yeah, I made myself sugar-free donuts. They're pretty good and I'm pretty excited about it. So yeah, that's been my week. I kind of ketoed it up a bit and I've been sticking with the sugar-free. And I've just been kind of playing with those ideas of just kind of being a little bit more conscious about what I'm putting in and what I'm doing, energy wise. I still haven't worked out, but hopefully just like really focusing more and more about like not even just the sugar but all the other junk that I'm putting in. I'm trying to avoid bread a little bit. It's hard. We always have like a day old croissant pile at work that you're allowed to eat, you know, and they're good and it's early in the morning. I gotta get there and I want something, you know. So I've been working more towards like almonds and my fruit thingies from Trader Joe's. But yeah, super stoked about the donuts, and that's been my week so far. Thanks so much for watching and I'll see you all next week. And yes, I put in a tablespoon instead of a teaspoon of vanilla, but it's okay. It's very vanilla, but it's okay.